What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Danie O. Welcome back to my channel. Wishing you a happy new year. Yeah, I'm late, I know. If you haven't done so already, make sure you hit the subscribe button, turn your notifications on so you don't miss a video. Okay, so now that the formalities are out of the way, let's get right into it. Let's talk stress, shall we? It is a very stressful time, personally, in my life, and it's a stressful time, I'm sure, for everybody. Everybody's like, yeah, you know, take it to the altar. And so I'm constantly trying to find ways to de-stress, but there's not much that we can do. I tried to book myself a vacation. Turns out you can't do that either. Like, we can't do ish in this place. I was talking to a friend of mine not too long ago, and she was like, I'm going to go floating. And I was like, floating, what's that? So I looked into it, because I thought it was like a spa. Like, well, she made it seem like it was a spa thing. And basically, it's float therapy, also known as sensory deprivation therapy, or a sensory deprivation tank. And what it is you basically float in, it's about, like, the place I went to, they say it's 900 pounds of Epsom salt. Now, for those of you who don't know, Epsom salt has a lot of therapeutic benefits. It has, it contains magnesium, which, you know, is good for a lot of biochemical reactions within your body. It can help with, like, depression and muscle aches and pains. You might have heard your grandma soaked in Epsom salt. So that's basically what it is. But in this case, they use the Epsom salt to really just cause you to float, and it creates like a buoyancy, I think they call it, and you start floating in the water and you're in the tank, which is like this huge, okay, before we go there, I tried to record the experience a little bit, but because of COVID, I didn't really know the extent of where my camera could go, and I don't want to be in the streets just shooting things and walking in with things. And anyway, it was just messy, so I shot what I could, and here's what it is. Okay, everybody, so I am just about ready to step on out to float Toronto. I'm gonna get my float on, and I'm going to try to chronicle this event, this outing, the best I can. Your girl can feel and fly, but what can I say, when in the days of COVID, where you can never actually leave the house, getting dressed to actually go somewhere has you feeling pretty pumped. I'm bringing my shower cap. Fingers crossed that I'm allowed to use it. I have arrived. I hope my green matcha latte, I drink this collagen latte every morning, doesn't constitute or doesn't contain caffeine, because I'm not supposed to have any, and I'm just taking it in that I drank that all the way here. Anyways, gonna go in. I'm not gonna bring the camera because I don't know how that's gonna be in there, and I'm supposed to be naked, so I mean, as much as you guys would want to show. Sorry. Let's see what this is all about, shall we?
This is the tank. And the big door. I'm about to lock myself up in here. The good news is, I can wear my shower cap. So I'm gonna get my hair organized and situated. And there's a shower here. Don't get this thing started.
Okay, so that was just kind of like, as you can see, the tank, it's like a little closed off box. So what happens is, take off your clothes, you take a shower, remove the oils and body like residue or whatever, you go and you float, legit float. The water feels a little like sticky or like gross to the skin. They give you earplugs that you put in your ears. Oh Lord, the residue! If you don't wash it off properly, like I had like, oh, so the shower cap, they let me put it on, but it was a dud because, I mean, it just kind of filled itself up. I guess I should have figured that, but I thought I was being slick, and yeah. So I thought I washed my hair really properly, but later in the day, there were parts that got like a little bit of salt residue in there, so you really have to scrub. Initially, I was like, alone with my thoughts, sensory deprivation, no phone, no nothing. Oh, and the gag is at one point, I realized that I forgot to pay the parking meter, so I was like, now I'm gonna get a ticket. I'm supposed to de-stress, not re-stress. I think just being cut off from all outside stimuli really kind of helps you like refocus, because I was panicking for like 2 seconds and then I was just like zen. And you can actually fall asleep in there because you will not sink. And I'm a big girl, so you think like, can you really float? Yes, yes, you can, you will float. I like the experience. It's just therapy in water form. Huh? Coming! Looks like my time here is done. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys again next week in my new video. Okay.